Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Diana, and today I wanted to make a quick video on the Venus signs because Valentine's Day is around the corner and everybody's trying to find their boo, their bae, or someone they can court, or if you're courting somebody you're currently dating, you're currently playing the field. I just wanted to give you guys some ideas on what you guys could do for your partner as far as their Venus signs goes, as far as like an activity to plan or a gift to get them or what they really appreciate. So I'm gonna very quickly go through all of the Venus signs and just explain what their perfect Valentine's Day would look like. And hopefully you guys can get some ideas on what to do for your partner. In astrology, Venus represents our love language. It represents what we enjoy. It represents how we love and how we want to be loved. And it's very important as far as like dating goes. So listen up. And of course, your Venus sign, when I say Venus, because I know I have a lot of new people on here that don't really understand astrology, your Venus sign is not the same as your sun sign. So your sun sign could be in Scorpio, but your Venus could be in Sagittarius, and that's gonna give you a different type of love language than, you know, a dark, scary Scorpio. So make sure that you find your Venus sign and your partner's Venus sign and listen to that. Of course, this is also gonna work if you have like a dominant, say I'm talking about Venus in Cancer and you have a lot of planets in Cancer, not necessarily just Venus, then you can listen to the Venus in Cancer as well. Okay, let's go over Venus in Aries. When I think of Venus in Aries and their perfect Valentine's Day, it has to be active. It has to be full of surprises and it has to be full of like an adrenaline rush. So whatever you do for your partner, I don't know, maybe get tickets to a sporting event that day, or get tickets to go do something physical, whether it's like going to like Top Golf or going rock climbing. They like that kind of thing. Venus and Taurus. Okay, Taurus is all about being comfortable and being around pleasurable five senses. Part of a Venus in Taurus, you're going to have to light the candles and make sure that it's candles that smell good. You're gonna really have to be attentive to what scents that they like, so start planning it now. You're going to want to bring them chocolates, but chocolates that they actually like, what they're used to. It's no surprises. You're gonna really have to have a good eye for detail when planning a Valentine's Day with the Taurus. They're gonna want flowers, but the flowers that they like the aroma to. They're going to maybe not necessarily want to go out for dinner because Venus in Taurus is more comfortable at home, where like, you know, on their couch that feels good. And maybe order taken, get some Postmates, but get Postmates of their favorite restaurant. Pizza, like, and there's this joint that they always go to get pizza. Get that pizza and get the dessert that they love, their favorite dessert. And you can even gift them, like if you're looking for a gift to buy a Venus in Taurus, get them their favorite perfume, all of that. Venus is all about the five senses, so you have to make sure that the date is aesthetically pleasing. And if it's at home, you're gonna have to work your ass off, clean the house, make it smell good, and they're gonna love you for it. And then, if you guys wanna end the night with sex, make sure you approach them in a slow and sensual way. Don't catch them off guard. Okay, Venus in Gemini. So Venus in Gemini, Gemini enjoys mental stimulation. Gemini enjoys communication. So, and Gemini enjoys being out in the public and just talking about themselves as well, because that's how they understand themselves. So with a Venus in Gemini, the perfect day is gonna start off maybe with a text message like, "You're so beautiful, I love you, have a great day, I'm like so thankful for being with you," or "I'm so thankful that, I don't know, God brought me into your life, like how are you doing, what do you wanna do today?" You wanna just like plan it out with a Venus in Gemini, because they're gonna enjoy verbal communication, right? And it could be through a text, it could be that you go on Facebook and you just put a picture of them and you talk about them. It's all about engaging, talking about them, start conversation. So maybe then their friends can join in on the conversation and be like, oh my God, you guys are so cute, whatever, right? So that's what you want to do with the Venus in Gemini. And as far as like a date or a gift, because Venus in Gemini is very social, they're probably gonna enjoy maybe going out to a Valentine's Day themed party, or they're going to enjoy being around just friends, not necessarily just you and them. Although if it is gonna be just you and them, it has to be like maybe a social place, maybe spend a day like at a bookstore, right? At Barnes and Noble, or take them to the library where they can like just lose themselves with like knowledge or curiosity. All of that is gonna be important. And even if you guys wanna go out to a nice restaurant, that's definitely nice, but make sure that like you Instagram it and all of that. Venus in Cancer. So Venus in Cancer, ultimately, they appreciate their privacy and they appreciate intimacy. So if you're dating a Venus in Cancer, they may not necessarily wanna go out and be like the center of attention at a restaurant. They rather probably just stay home and be intimate with you. Maybe get a nice blanket and like cuddle with them and talk about your feelings. Open up that day. Tell them why you appreciate them and why you love them and why they are amazing. Maybe you should do the cooking that day instead of letting them do the cooking. They ultimately just want, like I said, emotional intimacy if you're dating a Venus in Cancer. If you're gonna get them a gift, get them maybe something for their home. They always appreciate like home decor. If you're gonna get them a gift, you can get them sweets. Venus in Cancer has a good, has maybe a need for sweets sometimes, as they can get emotional and they can eat their life away through sweets. So they always appreciate that. But ultimately, I think with the Venus in Cancer, you guys have it easy because it's gonna be the love and the thought that counts. But as long as you're very thoughtful and you sit with them and hold them and coddle them and let them know that they're safe and protected, they're gonna be all over you for sure. Okay, Venus in Leo. This one's fun, right? Because Venus in Leo wants to go all out. So what I recommend with Venus in Leo is that you, days before, go out shopping, you know, get them a dress, get them like, tell them that they have to look fabulous for this great restaurant that you booked reservations for, because they want to be in the spotlight and they want to feel beautiful or handsome, and give them their, so that they know that their partner has their full attention, right? They want to be the center of attention where they walk into a restaurant and everybody turns heads, right? So if you're a woman and you're dating a Venus in Leo man, make sure that they get dressed up in their like tuxedo and their tie, and then compliment them all day. Just remind them how special they are and how or how handsome they are, or how they're the greatest thing alive, or the greatest person alive, I should say. And if you're gonna get them a gift, if you're gonna get them a gift, get them something extravagant, new outfit, all of that. You can get, really with Venus and Leo, you can really get them anything as long as you give them a lot of attention. It could be their favorite perfume, clothes, anything like that. And go all out. I mean, in the morning, wake up and get them balloons and chocolates and whatever. Write them a heartfelt note just talking about how amazing they are, and they will like drop their panties or their briefs for you. Okay, so let's talk about Venus in Virgo. Venus in Virgo is a little bit more chill and laid back. The main thing with Venus in Virgo, like I said, with earth signs, is that you have to be attentive. You have to pay attention to detail. So, and do practical things. Venus and Virgo's love language is a little bit more simple. They don't want to go all extravagant, but they want you to do practical things for them that day. You can take their car to get an oil change. You could take their car to go get new tires or a tune-up or whatever, a car wash. You could like do something practical around the home that day, whether it's like telling them, you know what, you just relax watch a movie, de-stress. I'll take care of the whole house. I'll scrub the baseboards, something like that. And they'll really enjoy that because it'll let them get off their mind. And also appreciate them. Maybe write them a letter about how, or in their Valentine's Day card, just explain how you notice everything that they do around the house or for you. And they'll really love that. As far as any gifts that you get them has to be practical. So they have to be able to put them to use. Meaning that you can, if you notice that they're, I don't know, that their hair straightener, let's say it's breaking, get them that because they'll use that. If you notice that they need, I don't know, something for their car that they will actually use, get them that for Valentine's Day. They will love that 10 times more than a box of chocolates because after all, they're probably watching their weight. Let's be real. Okay, so let's talk about Venus in Libra. Venus loves being in Libra, obviously, because Libra is the sign of relationships. It's the sign of one-on-one partnerships, right? So with Venus in Libra, if you're dating a Venus in Libra, they're gonna also appreciate a good conversation. They're gonna appreciate just spending time with you, with not necessarily a lot of other people around, but you guys having a really graceful, diplomatic conversation, because Venus and Libra also can be very girly. They're gonna appreciate that, you know, you're like, maybe you can get them some makeup or something for their hair and be like, you know what, take your time, get as beautiful as you want, no rush, because obviously Venus and Libra doesn't like to rush into things. They want to take their time and be really graceful about things. Maybe take them to a really nice restaurant. They will definitely appreciate that, where you guys could, maybe a restaurant that's not necessarily so loud, like the Cheesecake Factory, but maybe a little bit something that's a little bit more low key, and they will love you for that because they want to be able to conversate with you and get to know you, all of that. And then with a Venus in Libra, you can make a decision, because maybe they're not going to be quick to decide where they want to eat. So you plan it all out for them, so that way you don't have to stress them out with the mental energy of having to make a decision, right? Okay, so let's talk about Venus and Scorpio. So Venus and Scorpio, you have to have that passion that day. Like, you have to start the day and just go over to them and try to seduce them. For sure, they're gonna want a lot of sexual intimacy, for sure. But at the same time, Venus in Scorpio also wants depth. So they may not necessarily want the shallow side of Valentine's Day, that where you go out and you show your love to the world. Maybe they just want you to reveal a part of yourself that day that you haven't told them before, and they'll really appreciate you for that. They'll like drop their panties in a second for you for that. So having a really deep, intimate conversation about love and why you love them, and how you appreciate that, I don't know, they made you a better person, or how you have seen them evolve, spark up that type of conversation. If you're gonna get them a gift, Scorpio energy loves gifts that relate to the occult. So maybe get them like, maybe not necessarily a box of chocolates, but you can get them like a little gift basket full of like tarot cards, maybe a little bit of crystals, astrology books, all of that. Show them that you want to embrace the energy. And if they're the Venus and Scorpio type that aren't really into all that, I'm pretty sure that sex and intimacy and creating like synergy and making sure that they reach an orgasm is going to do the trick for them. Okay, so now I want to talk about Venus and Sagittarius. Again, this is a fire sign. So Venus and Sagittarius is going to want excitement that day. Surprise them with whatever you want. Like, get them tickets to go to a concert with you that day so they can have an adventure. Be spontaneous. Just be like, you know what? Call off your job today. Let's go do something fun. You can even, I don't know, take them to a restaurant that they've never tried before, because they love being spontaneous like that. And obviously a Venus in Sagittarius also just wants to explore, be like, you know what, let's drive down to Mexico today, let's just do something fun, right? If you're near the border or something, I don't know, let's go to another town next door and see what you'll find. Just spend the day with them and keep throwing surprise after surprise to them, and they'll love that and make that day like really fun and memorable. So find your best jokes or your best witty things to say to them, because they're really going to appreciate that. They love happy-go-lucky energy. So leave all your problems behind when you're with a Venus in Sagittarius celebrating Valentine's Day. Okay, Venus in Capricorn. Venus in Capricorn energy, like, I think that Capricorn is a sign that's very like predictable when it comes to courting and dating, especially on Valentine's Day. So if you're dating a Venus in Capricorn woman, she's gonna appreciate the little things, as far as like you coming up to her door, knocking on the door, meeting her parents, or if she's not living with her parents, she's just gonna appreciate you getting out of your car and opening the door for her. Like, it's all gonna be in the small gestures, because it's gonna show that you have respect. And also kind of with Venus in Libra. I didn't mention this earlier with Venus in Libra, but all of this is gonna be very important. At the same time, you may wanna invest in a fancy Gucci suit. You may wanna invest in, or if this is your girlfriend, give her a lot of money so that she can go get like her perfume, her hair done, and get herself a brand name outfit from, like, I don't know, what is Louis Vuitton or something. And if you're gonna get her a gift, make sure it's brand name. Venus and Capricorn women appreciate a man that they have, where the man looks like they have it all together, that they have a business going, they have money, all of that. And the way that they're gonna see that, it is kind of shallow, but it is gonna be through the things that you own, all of that. And if you don't have money, if you're a Venus in Capricorn that doesn't ball like that, that's okay. It's still going to be in the little things that you do with respect. So as long as that you know that you're trying, at dinner, wherever it is, high scale or low scale restaurant, have a good conversation about your goals. Have a good conversation about what you're doing, what you're planning, all of that, and the things that you've done as far as actions to reach your goals. All of that is going to be like such a penny dropper conversation for Venus in Capricorn. Venus in Aquarius is a little bit harder, because if you have somebody who has a Venus in Aquarius and they have a lot of Aquarius energy in their chart, they're probably going to be anti-Valentine's Day. They're going to be like, nope, that's just a social construct made up to spend money. But if you have like a Pisces, let's say, that has a Venus in Aquarius, they're going to appreciate maybe if you do something or you plan a party, a Valentine's Day party, and invite all of their friends, because Venus in Aquarius thrives off of their freedom to go talk to different people, especially if it's their friends. They may not just want it to be intimate. After all, Valentine's Day is also a day to appreciate friendships, and this is where Venus in Aquarius thrives, and just to appreciate love in general. I think that they'll appreciate that a little bit more. Or even if you do want to spend Valentine's Day that day with them, that's fine. But be like, hey, as a gift, I got you something so that you can go and enjoy this concert with your friends, or do that, because I just want to let you know that I want to give you your freedom so that you could go out and be yourself and be authentic. Also, if they're more of a Venus and Aquarius person that does want to be intimate, like say that they're, again, it could be a Pisces with a Venus and Aquarius side to them. If they do want that intimacy and that connection, that one-on-one date with you, you're going to have to be original. Like, you're going to have to think of something that nobody ever thought of. I don't know. Let's say like that day, like you notice that they're really like into Harry Potter, or they have this weird quirky thing about them. Expand on that and maybe get them like a Harry Potter book, or take them to the Harry Potter place in Universal Studios. Something like that, that expands their quirkiness. But you really have to pay attention to what is really unique and original about them, right? So then lastly, Venus in Pisces. So Venus in Pisces is going to just appreciate that you're with them that day. So if you have a Venus in Pisces that enjoys like getting high or being on drugs, get them some weed, you know, smoke them out. Talk about your dreams with them. Talk about the things that like really trip you out with them. That's gonna be amazing. If it's more of a Venus in Pisces who's not into that and who's more like religious or whatever, go to church with them. If it's a Venus in Pisces who, well, Venus in Pisces, because they accept everybody for who they are, you really don't have to do much to just show them their appreciation. They're gonna appreciate every little thing that you do. And because of that, I think that it's worth it to go all out for them so that they know that you're feeling the same way as them. Because a lot of times they can get caught up in being blindsided by love or with people that maybe don't necessarily feel the same way as them. And if they're a Venus in Pisces that, you know, has gotten you through something really shitty, like an addiction or a bad situation, just show them how much that means to them and maybe kind of give that same love back to them. So anyways, that was my description for the Venus signs. I hope I didn't miss any ones. I didn't. Okay, so that was my description for Venus through the zodiac signs. Please let me know if you guys have any questions and make sure to book your reading on onelovestrology.com. Bye.